Welcome back to the Return Sessions here at Ronnie Scott's Jazz Club. Thank you so much for your attendance and donations, and it keeps the musicians and us able to continue. Tonight we celebrate the 100th anniversary of Charlie Parker's birth, an extraordinary jazz titan who had a trailblazing career as a saxophonist and composer. Here to present some of his work is award-winning saxophonist Gilad Atzmon and his trio, and they are joined by the wonderful Sigamos String Quartet. Put your remote hands together and let's start the birthday celebrations.
Thank you so much. We are playing here without an audience, which is a very unique experience for all of us. No words to express how excited I am, or I was, to how excited I was to when I was asked to play this homage to the greatest saxophonist ever, for me to play the music of Bird in this wonderful venue, probably the best venue around. I mean, around more than Britain, the best venue in the world, a real jazz club. Is an incredible experience, even without audience. And for me to play the music of Bird means that black lives matter for real, because it's beyond the lives. It's the heritage, it's black music, it's the culture, it's freedom. Freedom, do you remember what freedom is? And I hope that you enjoy it. And I hope that you will be kind enough to buy all of us beer, either each of us or all of us. And I think that this is how you donate. This is how you support the club. This is how you support ourselves. I hope that you enjoy the music. We are going to continue with another Bird. We played with the arrangement. It is called a Bird tune. It is called If I Should Lose You.
Thank you. Thank you.
April in Paris. This was April in Paris. April wasn't a very happy month anywhere in the world. And in general, we aren't very happy. And music is really there to cheer us up. The tune that we are going to play to you now is an unusual take on Bird's music. It is so unusual that I am afraid that even Bird wouldn't recognize his own tune. And maybe I shouldn't even tell you what it is. Try to figure out.
Thank you.
have people listening from Romania. I don't know. These are the countries that are under lockdown at the moment. Or why do I have to mention them? South Africa. This is good. Manchester. Manchester is now a separate country. Finland, Germany, Argentina, Wales, Surrey, and for some reason Sussex is in kind of in a different column. Battery. It's much better. Shall we continue, or I have to wait for you sorting it out?
Well,
I can continue.
There we go.
You know, it's right now. It's working. I was really, really excited in 2016 about Donald Trump. Why do you laugh already? Yeah, some people were excited about Donald Trump. I was one. The reason that I was so excited is he promised to make America great again. And I thought to myself, what is the only thing that is really great about America? Jazz, obviously. So I was sure that jazz is coming back big time. And look at us. We are playing to you in an empty room, terrified by a dangerous disease. It's frightening. Anyway, we'll keep jazz alive. With Trump or without Trump, what are we going to play now? What is that thing called Trump? What is that thing called love? Yeah. All right. No politics. You do it. The most inspiring for us musicians thing about Bird is that absolute freedom. And I think that not many people remember what freedom is all about. But the big thing for me about jazz is this unique ability to make freedom into a form of poetic resistance. And at the moment, a lot of people who dissent or have different opinions are subject to a lot of orchestrated violence. Their culture is canceled, their jobs are taken. And for me, jazz is all about putting an end to suffering, to misery, to oppression. The tune that we are going to play to you now is inspired by Bird, by Train, by Elvin Jones, by McCoy, by a big community of jazz revolutionaries. And many other musicians all over the world. It is called the Burning Bush.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
the Zygamos Quartet. So as I mentioned before, you're more than welcome to make sure that they are getting pissed before they go home. And I'll introduce you to each of them. And I'll give you enough time to buy them beer or a cocktail. When it comes to me, you can always, if you belong to the right gender, you can give me a kiss. And it costs much more. And if you don't belong to the right gender, it costs a lot more. But, you know, musicians, especially now, it's important that you know that musicians never, never, never prostitute themselves unless there is some money involved. Anyway, on cello, Ian Birch. Yeah. Bruce White on viola. Marian Ains, who put it together for us. You know, in Corona time, it's not very easy to find musicians who are willing to play in proximity of actually just 90 centimeters from each other. You actually keep the 1 meter thing, huh? It's amazing. It's the safest. It was your idea? Ah, you do it with the... And Janet, you have to pronounce your name because I'll get it wrong.
Oh, Janet Erushkarne.
Is it good? Am I good? It's very close, huh? And we cannot get any closer than that. I'll introduce you later because I'm buying time here. Wow, there is a speaker. I'm in your speaker. I'm sorry about it. I didn't ask for it. So this is really a tribute to Bird. And Bird is a person that so fundamental to everyone who plays jazz. You cannot think of playing jazz without listening to Bird and trying to understand what he tried to achieve. But I must pay an homage to another great saxophonist, I think one of the best saxophonists in the world, who passed away 2-3 days ago. British guy, great inspiration for all of us and many other musicians around the world. I'm talking about Peter King, a guy who really managed to make jazz sounds authentic. And we will dedicate the next Bird tune to Peter King, because maybe it sounds more like Peter King than like Bird. It's in between. To Peter King, now is the time for a change. Thank you. Chris Higginbottom on drums. It's so strange for musicians to play in a room. Let's try it again. Chris Higginbottom on drums. You're paid also for being audience. Dave Chamberlain, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah! Probably one beer won't be enough for you. No. 10 beers. Get your pockets, guys. And the one and only, Ross Stanley, ladies and gentlemen. And we are going to play one more tune. And you probably realize that many of the tunes that we played here tonight are from this legendary, precious recording of Birds with Strings. Carnegie Hall, I think. What was it, 42? I should have... 40, huh? Two separate dates. So 42 and 43. No? I wanted to kind of record an album with strings and told me, how are you going to call it? Are you going to call it G-strings? And I dropped the idea. Never mind. Anyway, Bird with Strings, ladies and gentlemen. I think that the most beautiful arrangement, the most beautiful track on this precious recording is Laura. And Laura is a very important tune for me because I was 17 years old in Jerusalem preparing myself to go to the army and willing to do everything they told me to do. And out of the blue, I wasn't a musician or didn't think about jazz at all. And out of the blue, there was a track from this album, Bird with Strings. It was Laura, and it made me change my mind. I decided to be a saxophonist. And it took me a few years before I could play it, before I realized what tune it was. But it is a gorgeous tune and a gorgeous arrangement. Here it comes. Thank you. the Zygmunt Quartet. Thank you so much. The Orient House Ensemble. I'm glad this was a tribute to the giant saxophonist Charlie Bird Parker. And we hope to see you all one day in a club listening to us. But for the time being, make sure that you do whatever you can to support jazz, to support jazz clubs, to support this club in particular. I don't want to know how much they pay rent and so on and so on. And it's a big effort for them to do all this kind of live streaming. And make sure that you also support us. Maybe we go more than just one beer. Thousands of, no, you can buy one beer to all, for all of us, or is there a limit of how much money they can?
No.
We accept all kind of currencies, cryptocurrencies, shekels, dollars, rubles. Thank you so much. And thank you to Ronnie Scott for having us. Night, night.